Hello everyone, hi and welcome to the channel of Wall Street Mojo. To know more about this video, written down value method, watch the video till the end, and also if you're new to this channel, then you can subscribe us by clicking the bell icon that's given below. Welcome everyone, and today's topic is basically an accounting tutorial topic where we'll be focusing more on the depreciation part, which is hitting the impact income statement, which has an expense side where depreciation comes into picture. And for calculating the depreciation, there are different formulas, there are different methods with which you can calculate depreciation: written down value method, you have straight line method, and so on and so forth. So this is one of the method that we are going to learn today. So what we are going to do is we are going to learn how to calculate the WDV. That's going to be the first part of the discussion. Then we'll do the written down value method versus the straight line method of depreciation, the comparison portion, how things go about. We'll see the advantages, the disadvantages, and how the WDV depreciation offsets the repair requirements. These are broad outline of what exactly we are going to do today. Well, let's get started. At the first and the foremost thing, as you can see, the written down value method is the cost of the asset minus the salvage value of the asset. So we see two things. First, the cost of the asset, that is when it was purchased, the value, then minus the salvage value of the asset, that is the final value that remains after the number of years into the rate of depreciation. So this is what we are going to learn. Well, the written down value method is a depreciation technique. It basically applies a constant rate of depreciation to the net book value. Constant rate of depreciation that applies to the net book value of the asset each year, and thereby recognizing more depreciation expense in the early years of life of the asset. And you can say that of the life of the asset, and less depreciation in the later years of the life of the asset. So in short, this method of accelerates the recognition of the depreciation expense in a very systematic way, and it helps the businesses recognizes more depreciation in the early years. So it is also known as diminishing balance method, or you can say that it is known as declining balance method. You can use any of those two names. So let me run you through this whole formula before we work on the examples and some numerical numbers posing the same. So first and the foremost, how to calculate WDV depreciation. Let's try and understand this. So let's understand. Let's understand the same with the help of an example. Let's say Whitefield Company, they purchased a machinery of $12,000 with a useful life of 7 years and a residual value of 2000. So this is years, this is a residual value, and the depreciation rate that is standing closely around 20%. So how does this whole solution will work? So machinery costing, years, residual value, depreciation. So let me calculate the depreciation amount. To get the amount, what we are going to do is the machinery value less the residual value into the rate of depreciation, that comes to $2,000. So the depreciation is 2000, right? And the value at the end of the year is going to be, well, it is something like this: the machinery value less the residual value less the depreciation amount, that comes down to 8000. So value at the end of the year is 8000. So depreciation as per written down value method will go something like this. Let me put a table down here to make you explain the entire concept. Then the depreciation value at the end of the year, so 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, well, the depreciation will be 20%. So from here I'll just take down the formula: 12,000 less 2000 year into 20%. So that comes down to 2000. So this is just a depreciation, how exactly that has been calculated. If you want, you can copy down the entire formula here, or I'll just delete this one. And the value at the end of the year is going to be how much? 8000. How? It will be your machine value less the depreciation amount and the value and the residual value. In the similar fashion, then value at the end of the year, it comes down to 8000 here. So you will calculate 8000 into 0.2. So just copy down the formula here. Okay, the depreciation. So this is the depreciation. I'm just gonna delete this. Just putting down here. So value at the end of the year is going to be 8000 minus this value, 6400. Just copy down this. Well, we have all the answers. So that we save some time here. So similarly, we can do the calculation for year 2 to 5. So Whitefield depreciated the machinery using the WDV method, and we can observe that the depreciation expense amount is higher during the initial year and kept reducing, assets getting older. So as you can see, 2000, 1600, 1280, and there is decline in the value. Now, let me make you understand the difference between the WDV method, WDV, versus the straight line method. So one of the most common and the popular types of the WDV method is the double declining balance method. So this method applies the depreciation two times the straight line method. The word double signifies these aspects. So the method is suitable for the assets that quickly lose their value and as such requires higher depreciation. So let's understand the difference between the WDV and the straight line depreciation with the help of an example. Let's say a company called Masson Limited purchased a machinery costing of $25,000 for a specific project, and it is expected useful life. Let's consider it as 5 years. The machine is expected to have a residual value. I'm just going to write residual value standing at 5 years. Sorry, residual value, not 5 years, 5,000. So how we are supposed to calculate here? Well, these are the three useful items that is given. So with the help of the straight line method, it comes down to 25 divided by 5, 5000. Straight line, you can say the rate at which it is going to go, and the straight line depreciation rate, let's say 20%. If this is 20%, okay, so the rate is 20%, okay, and the double declining balance method, let's say is 0.4, accumulated depreciation is 10,000 till date, so your depreciation is going to be is equal to the double declining rate balance into your cost of the machine minus the accumulated depreciation till date. This is 10,000. The amount comes down to 6,000. So the straight line rate is the cost of the machine minus the residual value divided by the useful life. Well, what you can see here, this is the reducing method. So 25 minus 5. So this 20 divide by 5, so it comes to 4000. So I'm 5000, it should be 4000. So the straight line depreciation method rate is calculated with the help of how does this exactly rate comes into picture? Well, this 4000 divide by 25 minus 5, that comes down to 20%, right? So the calculation of the depreciation can be done using this formula. So now the accumulated depreciation in total accumulated depreciation is going to be 10,000 plus 6,000, that comes to 16,000, right? So the depreciation as per double declining method is depreciation, year, and the accumulated depreciation. So year 1, 2, 3, and 4. So the amount is equal to 25,000 into 40%, right? That's the double declining method. So that comes down to 10,000. So the balance here onwards is going to be is equal to 25,000. Okay, minus. So you can write the balance amount here. The balance at the end of the year is going to be 25,000. The asset value minus 10,000. Just keep it that way, and it's always going to be 15,000 into 40%, 6,000, and so on and so forth. You will do things and just knock things here. You will get entire depreciation rate. And if you want to calculate the total accumulated depreciation till date, so the first year will be 10,000, then 10,000 plus 6, and then just keep going. So you'll get answer 21,760. So similarly, we can do the calculation for year 3 and 4. Well, I have explained you a couple of things here. I hope things are on a crystal clear note. I'll make you understand some of the advantages of WDV method. Let's begin. The first one. See, the WDV method helps in determining the depreciated value of the asset, which is helpful in determining the price at which the asset should be sold. Second, it applies higher amount of the depreciation in the initial year of the useful life of the asset and is an ideal method to record the depreciation of the asset which lose their value quickly. An example of such assets can be technological development software by an IT company. By recognizing accelerated depreciation in the early years, the business can determine its fair market value of the balance sheet before the technology becomes outdated. Now, the higher depreciation during the initial year results in, you can say, reduced taxes, or we can say the deferral of the taxes, to later years for the business on account of the lower net income, but increased cash profits as depreciation is a non-cash expense. Well, there are some disadvantages. Always there is a different side of the coin. Starting with the first one, the written down value method recognizes higher depreciation during the early years and may not be ideal method of depreciation for those assets which have uniform utility throughout the useful life and does not suffer from the risk of obsolescence and technological changes. Higher depreciation expense due to these method results in reduced net income for the business. Now, as I told you, I had another topic also to be under discussion. How this WDV depreciation offsets repair requirements? Well, the method is based on the premise that certain assets not just have limited use and need to be depreciated with higher values during the useful life. Okay. So as to show the true fair value of the asset on the balance sheet. But also the depreciation method is apt for those assets when they require higher repairs in the later stage of the life. So by applying higher depreciation during the initial year when the repairs requirement is less, and lesser depreciation during the later years when repair requirement is more, a balancing act is achieved under this method. Right? Let us understand an example, a short one. Mayer Inc. purchased a machinery, let's say costing 80,024 with a useful life of 4 years with a no residual value. Simple, zero. So the company has incurred the following expenditure, let's say in the form of repairs of the machinery during the last 5 years, let's say the year and the repair cost 2015. I'll just take every year as 2018. Let's say some repair cost is rising every year because as the machinery gets older, the repair cost increases. So let's understand the point discussed above using the two different depreciation method in a WDV and straight line depreciation method, and understand how using these two, applying higher depreciation in case of WDV during the initial year when the repair requires less, and the less depreciation during the later year when a repair requirement is more, is a sort of a balancing act. The calculation of the WDV depreciation can be done something like this. Well, talking about depreciation amount, cost of the asset, well, 80,000 divided by 4, so it's going to be 20,000. Okay. And the depreciation rate should be easy for you guys now. 20,000 divided by 80,000, that's 25%. So the calculation of the depreciation will be 80,000 into 25%, right? Now, so this is going to be your depreciation, which is 20,000. The repair charges is 2,000. So the total maintenance charge is going to be 20,000 plus 2,000, 20,000, right? So let me give you an analysis under both the method, depreciation, repair charge, and total maintenance charge. This I'm doing under WDV first. Okay, so as I said, year 1, so let's say 2015, 2016, 2017, and 2018. So my depreciation is going to be 80,000 into 25%, that's 20,000. Repair cost is 2,000. Total expense, if you see, comes down to 22,000, right? Now 60,000, because it's 80 minus 20 into again 25%, that comes down to 15,000. Repair is 4, 6, 8. Just I'll keep adding every number down here. Then once you deduct this amount, 45,000 into 25%, and last but not the least, 33,750 into 25%. Well, this is how your WDV will react. Let me show you the same thing under SLM method. SLM is like, you know, it's going to be 20,000 every year. Well, you can see the difference how things are going. The total maintenance charges, that is depreciation, you see, there is a continuous balance maintenance. Here you can see it's 22 24 26 28, it's on a similar line. So similar, we can do the calculation for the rest of the year. Thus we can observe that, you know, the WDV method ensures that the higher depreciation expense in the initial year and lower depreciation expense in the later years helps in offsetting the higher repairs and maintenance charge as the asset becomes older. So conclusion: written down value method is an appropriate method for matching the expenses to revenues, as most of the long-lived assets generate more benefits in the early years of the economic life and fewer benefits in the later years of their life, and it ensures the same by more depreciation expense in the early years and fewer depreciation expense in the later years of the asset under useful. Well, that's it for this particular topic. If you have enjoyed and loved watching this video, don't forget to hit the like button. You can comment on this video and subscribe us to our channel for all the latest updates. Thank you everyone once again for joining the session. Cheers.